Okay, we're back at the payroll register. Now you'll notice that I scrolled over a little bit. We're kind of over in this section of it now, okay? The check numbers have been entered for you and you can continue those numbers in future pay periods. Total earnings minus all the deductions will give you net pay. The taxable earnings section is for the earnings that are subject to the tax and not the tax itself. We've already discussed the first two columns under taxable earnings. The next column you'll see is FUTA taxable earnings column. FUTA is a tax that is assessed on the employer. That's why you didn't see a deduction column for FUTA. We're told in Figure 7.3 that FUTA is assessed on the first $7,000. So let's refer back to the employee's earnings records spreadsheet. Recall that Bono's cumulative earnings prior to this pay period were $10,293. He exceeded the threshold prior to this pay period. As a result, none of his earnings will be subject to FUTA this pay period. And the next employee we see is Ferguson. Ferguson's cumulative earnings prior to this pay period were $23,125. None of Ferguson's earnings will be subject to the tax this pay period either. The next employee is Ford. Ford's cumulative earnings prior to this pay period were $6,300. Because that's below the threshold, we know that some of the earnings from this pay period will be subject to the tax. Ford had total earnings of $1,220 this pay period. $6,300 plus $1,220 equals $7,520. Ford will exceed the threshold this pay period. So we take the threshold of $7,000 and subtract the cumulative earnings prior to this pay period of $6,300 to arrive at a taxable earnings of $700. Back to the payroll register. The next column is pseudo taxable earnings. Figure 7.3 tells us that the employer must pay a pseudo tax on the first $9,750 of gross earnings. We know from looking at the threshold for FUTA that Bono and Ferguson both exceeded the $9,500 threshold prior to this pay period. And remember that Ford had earned $6,300 prior to this pay period and had earned $7,520 through this pay period. Because Ferguson did not exceed the threshold, all of Ferguson's total earnings will be subject to the tax. Enter $1,220 in the taxable earnings for SUTA. The next section is called labor cost distribution. We'll enter each employee's total earnings into a column for the appropriate department. Refer to Figure 7.2 in your book. We're told that Bono is a mixer operator in the plant. Enter his total earnings in the plant column. We're told that the department for the next five employees. Enter the total earnings in the appropriate column. Ryan is an electrician in the plant, so enter his total earnings in the plant column. Sikowski is a supervisor in the plant, so enter his earnings in the plant column. The last two departments are given. Total all the columns in the payroll register.